aliens will be caught.
How do you know my name? I don't think we've met.
What? Don't tell me you don't remember. Let's just say that I gave your sister a helping hand during her journey a long, long time ago.
You helped Sarah on her journey?
I... No, sadly. But I am on your...
I don't even know you.
Well, you're just... Ooh, I...
Wait. Never...
Welcome to our...
Welcome back, Light. Now step forward and offer your Aradia so we can give time back to the world. Pray.
As the world dies around me, I offer this blessing. Is this fruit from the Light?
With the power of Aradia, you have successfully extended the world's life. Come here and I'll explain. This is Yggdrasil, the Tree of Life. It's a holy tree and its life force is entwined with that of the world. Aradia gives Yggdrasil the power to grow. As the tree grows stronger, so too does the world. With enough Aradia, you can extend its life and push back the Day of Destruction. Up to 13 days, after which God awakens.
So the more Aradia I can collect, the bigger that tree will grow. And the bigger the tree, the longer the world has before Doomsday.
The destruction began 500 years ago, but you know that. It was when the Chaos first flooded into our world. Most of the world was lost immediately under the Ocean of Chaos. Only one small region survived. The survivors call their island of refuge Nova Chrysalia. The Chaos brought destruction, and a kind of immortality too. Suddenly everyone stopped growing. It was like we'd lost our time. But if that was a gift, it was a poisoned one. We could not age, and neither could new life be born. There were no more children. But although we were ageless, and so humanity began a new chapter of its history, eventually new creeds took hold and new legends created. One of these told of the Savior, humanity's last chance for salvation. Light, do you understand? The more souls you save,
thank you.
In this world, all the clocks count to 12, but that wasn't always the case. Back in the old days, all clocks went to 13. Somehow, when the but happened, it did. Space-time has been 2 hours of every day. There's a hard truth we must... There are thousands of people...
I've only got a handful of days. There just isn't enough time, right?
This will sound cold, but you need to be efficient. Saving people who are suffering under the heaviest burdens will give you more Aradia, which is good for us. But the greater the burden, the more you might have to do before that soul can be saved. Sometimes, solving someone's problem might just take too long.
You're saying I shouldn't waste time on helping the hard cases. I've got to pick and choose who gets saved.
Of course it would be best if you could save everyone, but you can't. It's a numbers game, Light. The more souls you save, the more Aradia you can gather and offer to the tree. The time spent helping one person might be better spent saving the souls of 10 others.
Efficiency by volume, is that it? A numbers game, like you say. Control costs and maximize profits. What is it that they say? Time is money.
There are certain areas within Nova Chrysalia that I want you to focus on. 5 locations where I'm picking up anomalous chaos readings.
And I'm guessing one of those locations is right where Snow is.
Yes, exactly. The palace in the city of Usnan. There is another spot, in the heart of Luxarian, the Holy City. One more in the scorching sands of the Dead Dunes. And finally, I've measured large chaos fluctuations at 2 locations in the Wildlands.
4 regions, 5 locations.
To be more precise, the goals are people, not places. For example, the chaos activity in and around Snow's palace is linked to him, and the darkness in his heart. It's the same kind of chaos that I'm picking up in the other 4 locations.
And you want me to find these 5 people?
They're your priority, yes. Those people have massive burdens on them. The fate of many rests on their shoulders, and that makes your task all the harder. Helping them will not be easy, even for God's handpicked savior. But I can help you.